Nitro K-9, real dog training. Greetings, dog lovers everywhere. You're listening to Nitro K-9's Real Dog Training. I am Dave Tucker, and today's episode, The Dog Park. Nitro K-9 is owned and operated by Steve Walter, the dog trainer extraordinaire, located right here in Seattle. Of course, Steve has an international following because of his expertise and his tips about dog training, and that's what we'd like to share with you here today. For more information, go to the Nitro K-9 webpage, nitrok9.com. Because if you're interested in dog training, Steve has lots of tips and information to help you in your dog training journey. If you've got a question for Steve, go to the Nitro K-9 webpage, click on the contact tab at the top right corner of the page, and send that question to Steve. Let him know that you're listening to the podcast because Steve loves his listeners. Now, today's episode, The Dog Park. I have to say, I have mixed feelings about dog parks. On one hand, they're often the only place for people who live in the city to take their dogs to really let them run, really let them get exercise. On the other hand, though, they do have several risks brought about by other dogs and dog owners in the park. Things like disease or bad behavior by other dogs. Not to mention the antics of the overly passionate but sometimes misled dog owners. Steve doesn't take his dogs to dog parks, and for the most part, he doesn't recommend them to others. That said, I completely understand why people use them. So Steve thought it would be good to provide some advice to those who choose to use a dog park. There are lots of guides out there for doggy etiquette at the dog park, and some of it is good advice. But the thing to remember is that you cannot control other people, and you cannot control other dogs. You can only control yourself and your own dog. I'm not going to talk about the obvious guidelines, like making sure your dog is up to date on shots, or having a good recall. You know that already. So now, drumroll please. Here are Nitro K-9's top 8 guidelines for taking your dog to the dog park. Number 1, make sure your dog is calm. Okay, it's understandable that dogs get super excited about going to the dog park. It's their chance to run around and play, a way to release pent-up energy, and a chance to meet new friends and visit old pals. But a dog that goes into a dog park overexcited is more likely to get into scuffles. So take your time going in. Walk around calmly before you go in, ideally at a heel. Only when you're both feeling calm and relaxed should you actually go into the park. When you're calm, your dog is looking to you for guidance. Secondly, know when not to go in. Just because you're at the dog park doesn't mean you absolutely have to go inside it. And let's be honest, sometimes you shouldn't. If there's a dog that your dog doesn't like, don't go in. If there's a dog playing fetch with a ball and your dog is ball possessive, stay outside. If there's a dog already in there that looks like a troublemaker, probably better to walk away. If you have a small, fearful dog and there are a lot of rambunctious big dogs, please don't go in. Ultimately, it comes down to knowing your dog and how he is likely to interact with the dogs in the park. Number 3, know when to leave. Just because you're at the dog park doesn't mean you have to stay until your puppy is all worn out. If your dog gets into a brouhaha, it's probably time to go. If there's a problem dog coming in the gate, time for an early exit. And if your dog is anxious or just not having a good time, take him somewhere where he's more comfortable. And it's not a bad idea to leave when the dog park becomes too crowded. Energy levels can ramp up really fast when there are too many dogs in a confined space. Point number 4. Remember, it's about the dogs. Dog parks would be a far safer place if the dog owners paid as much attention to the dogs' conversations as they did their own. Sadly, they often get wrapped up in their own socialization and forget the dogs. And it's not just about preventing fights either. Though that's obviously important. It's also about getting to know your dog. How else would you know if the dog's feeling anxious and needs to leave? How else are you going to identify whether he's bullying other dogs so you can then work on that in training? The more you work and observe your dog, the more you'll be able to understand what dogs are really saying to each other. Point number 5. Don't take treats with you, period. Food at the dog park is just a bad idea. Lots of scuffles arise from somebody pulling out the cookies, attracting multiple dogs, and then lo and behold, one of them turns out to be possessive around food. Or worse, the cookie pusher's dog gets protective and snaps at all the other dogs begging for a handout. My friends have a dog who actually scouts out people with dog treats and continues to nudge their pockets with her nose until she gets rewarded. It sounds cute, but it could lead to a problem. Point 6. Don't use the dog park to rehabilitate a dog. Socialization is important, but if you have a fearful or an aggressive dog, turning him loose in a dog park isn't the way to solve this issue. Think about his safety. Instead, socialize the dog with selected other dogs while on leash, one-on-one. Our 7th point, keep an eye out when the professional dog walkers show up. No, I don't have anything against professional dog walkers. Some of my best friends are dog walkers. After all, it is a service also provided by Nitro K-9. There can be an issue with dog walkers, though, who pick up multiple dogs and then take them all out for outings at the dog park. The reason is simple. Dogs are pack animals. When these dogs get to know each other, they often pack up. I've seen one dog walker take 12 dogs into a dog park, and then this pack turns into a gang of bullies threatening other dogs and sometimes the people too. Be safe and steer clear of this. And the last point, don't make the dog park your only outing. All right, so this isn't technically a dog park tip, but it's worth saying that dog park runs should never be the only outing your dog ever gets. Yes, they can be great, but they aren't substitutes for daily walks and getting out in the real world and working on good healing and obedience. I hear people say that they absolutely have to go to the dog park every day to tire out their dog because a tired dog is a good dog. Sorry, don't buy that one. Yes, a tired dog is less likely to misbehave, but a trained dog is better equipped to conduct himself properly, whether tired or completely fresh. Tiring out a dog for behavioral reasons is just avoiding the problem, and if you get busy and can't take that dog-exhausting trip to the park, everybody's going to suffer. A trained dog is a good dog because he has self-control and the resilience to deal with it. And if you really want a tired dog, work on your training. The mental stimulation is just as tiring. So thanks for listening to this episode. If you're enjoying this podcast, please subscribe and tell your dog lover friends, especially if they're interested in dog training. Steve loves to pass on the information, and so many people have benefited from his wisdom. For more information about Nitro K-9 and more resources for training your dog, go to nitrok9.com. You've been listening to Nitro K-9 Real Dog Training. My name is Dave Tucker, reminding you that a trained dog is a happy dog, and at the other end of that leash is a happy dog owner.
Nitro K-9 Real Dog Training.
Episodes of Real Dog Training are released on the 10th, 20th, and 30th of each month. For more information, go to nitrok9.com.